Let's start with a right angle triangle with the legs of 16 and 12. Then we will copy this triangle and rotate it by 90 degrees so that the bottom leg of the first triangle is located at the same line as the hypotenuse of the second triangle, just as shown on the sketch. Now we will inscribe the circle inside the intersection between those two triangles. The question is it possible for us to find the area of this red circle? If you want to try this problem for yourself, this would be a great time to pause the video and then come back to check the solution. Alright, so let's get to the solution. So first thing that we're going to do is to label the vertices of our right triangle as A, B and C. We will also label two remaining vertices of our copied triangle as D and E. And we can label the point of intersection between those two triangles as F. Now let's focus on the triangle ABC. We will label its acute angle at the point A as alpha and the acute angle at the point B as beta. Now, since the angle at the point C is a 90 degree angle, that means that the sum of the angles alpha and beta must be 90 degrees. Now, we will use the Pythagorean theorem to calculate the hypotenuse of our triangle. We can say that hypotenuse AB squared is equal to leg BC squared plus the leg CA squared. Now we will just substitute our values and simplify. And we will get that AB squared must be equal to 400, which means that the hypotenuse AB must be equal to 20. Now let's go back to our previous sketch. We can also label the angles for the triangle CDE. Since this triangle is congruent with the triangle ABC, that means that the angle at the point E must be alpha and the angle at the point C must be beta. Now, since we already know that the sum of the angles alpha and beta is equal to 90 degrees, that means that the remaining acute angle at the point C must be equal to alpha. With this in mind, we can easily conclude that the triangle ACF is actually an isosceles triangle. That means that the line FA of this triangle must be equal to the line FC. Furthermore, we can conclude that the triangle CFB is also an isosceles triangle. That means that the line CF is equal to the line FB. Now we can notice that the point F actually divides our hypotenuse AB into two identical pieces. Since we know that hypotenuse is equal to 20, we can easily find the length of FA to be equal to 20 over 2, which is equal to 10. And we got our new values. Now, with this new knowledge, let's go back to our original sketch. Here we can label the radius of our red circle as R. Now, there's a really neat formula that combines the area of the triangle with the radius of the inscribed circle. And that formula states that the area of the triangle, in this case, triangle CFB, must be equal to the radius of the inscribed circle times the semi-perimeter of this triangle. Now we can use this formula to find the radius of our circle to be equal to the area of our triangle over the semi-perimeter. Now let's try to find the area of our triangle CBF. You can do this in multiple ways. You can do this using the Heron's formula, you can do this using the Pythagorean theorem to find the height of this triangle and then find its area, but in this case I will use a little shortcut. Let me show you. Let's first clear our image a little bit. And let's first find the area of our triangle ABC. The area of this triangle is equal to the product of its legs divided with 2, so in our case that is 12 times 16 over 2, which is equal to 192 over 2, and get that the area of our triangle ABC is equal to 96 squared units. Now let's set our attention to the line CF. This line is actually called the median of the triangle. Just to explain this to you, the median of a triangle is a line segment joining the vertex of the triangle to the midpoint of its opposite side. It basically bisects the opposite side, dividing it into two equal parts. And the median of a triangle, furthermore, divides the triangle into two triangles having the same area. So in our case, that means that the triangle AFC and the triangle CFB must have the same area. Since the area of our big triangle is equal to 96, that means that both of those triangles must have the area of 48 squared units. Alright, so now we have the area of our triangle CFB. Now let's find the semi-perimeter. We can find the semi-perimeter of the triangle by dividing the sum of all of its sides with 2. In our case, this is sides 10, 10 and 12. So we will get that that is 32 over 2. That means that the semi-perimeter of our triangle is equal to 16. Now we will substitute our values back into first equation for the radius, and we will get that radius is equal to 48 over 16, which means that the radius of our red circle must be equal to 3. Now it's easy for us to find the area of the circle as r squared pi. We can substitute the value of r and get that that is 3 squared pi, which means that the area of our red circle must be equal to 9 pi squared units, and this is our solution. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, leave a like and subscribe to the channel for more content like this. Of course, if you found any other way to solve this interesting problem, please write it down in the comment section below. And as always, until next time, see you all and take care.